guys, so I'm here the Cape Point. So obviously we just got here. This is the bus. Sightseeing. Took about 3 hours to get here. It's really a long walk, but it's really a long distance from Sea Point, so it's about 3 hours. But also there was traffic in the so but this place looks so beautiful, guys. I've never seen something like this before. I'm just gonna show you guys a rough. So guys, here I can take a walk to the lighthouse. There it is. So I'm about to take this 15-minute walk. Here's the Antarctic Ocean. lighthouse. So let me also take a walk.
As prior to the construction of the Table Bay Harbour, which only occurred in the British period during the mid-1880s, ships that were anchored in Table Bay simply sank in violent storms. If I remember correctly, the fatality list one night was at least 30 ships were sunk in one instance. Now, if you look at the lay of the peninsula ahead of us, you can see it comes in quite deep, as well as the fact that the mountain up to our left acts as a breakwater to the wilder Atlantic side. This portion of our peninsula lends itself to being what's termed a natural harbour or a natural port of call. So no surprises then that it's been a shipyard for more than 250 years by at least four different countries. Currently it's the main head office of the South African Naval Forces as well. So hopefully we'll get to see some of their vessels on our way out a bit later as well. But for now, ladies and gentlemen, we are going to be visiting the penguin enclosure. Now, very importantly, again, I'll announce when it's safe to start getting up. But we do have to do a bit of walking from where the bus will be parked. And again, it's going to be your responsibility to make sure you make it back to the bus on time by yourself. So do pay attention as to where we're walking. Please don't get distracted by the many distractions on the way, because the sooner we get to the penguins, the more time you guys get to decide how you'd like to spend after. So make sure you have your ticket with you. It's going to be a really far walk back to the bus if you don't have your ticket. You won't be allowed into the enclosure without it. And no distractions. We need to walk as a group. So I'll be leading the group, getting you guys there, and then processing your tickets on arrival as well. Typically, people spend between 10 to 20 minutes observing the penguins on the boardwalk. And then the balance of your time to do a bit of exploring. There's some really nice snacky shops along the way where you can buy things like sandwiches, good coffee, even cake and ice cream, homemade ice cream. There's even a little beach where if you manage your time well, you can go for a bit of a swim or even dip your toes in the warmer water on the False Bay side. Sometimes there are even penguins roaming about on the beach for extra pictures, but we'll do that once we've actually been to the enclosure first. So we're going to make the departure time for this particular stop a bit longer, which is good news, seeing that you folks have been so punctual. We're going to depart from this stop, folks, at 6.
Hey, penguin. You're so beautiful.
They've only been coming here for about 30 years. They like to burrow in the ground where they live.